Definitely a challenge. Once again, if you are just joining me, this is Doc Stout. I'm doing Murlocs Invade Naxxramas. Going to attempt to take the Warlock Murloc deck in against Noth the Plaguebringer, who has been giving me some trouble this morning. It appears that anybody who gets to make free guys every time one of my little guys dies is pretty good against Murlocs.
Plaguebringer!
Another soul for the collection.
Your soul shall be mine!
I cannot imagine a better starting hand, even though I fear he's just gonna one for one my guys. Get free dudes of his own. Well, that's pretty good against me in this situation. When he death rattles, he'll kill everything. Which means I at best I two for one myself. I think we just draw a card and pass turn.
Rise, my soldier! Rise
dead.
And fight once more!
Out, you're dead.
I guess I gotta be just a little grindier right now. And I don't think I want to summon any guys with one toughness in the current board state.
Job's done.
I need to be able to drop a Cold Light Seer and a Murloc on the same turn. That's not something that I can do right now. Because that's just a battle cry. I want to get maximum Murloc for my buck here. Which means that a Grimscale Oracle and Cold Light Seer isn't going to cut it. I guess we just Flesh Eating Ghoul and pass. Luckily, I have multiple Cold Light Seers. So these guys can actually survive.
Yeah.
Job's done.
What we do?
Gotta silence that thing. I got four left. I could charge twice. Now I think the best thing to do is here. Grimscale Oracle. Bluegill Warrior. Hit in for some major damage. He's threatening 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Well over lethal. Meaning that I'm actually going to have to use some of my own Murlocs here. Of course. Alright, that's handled. Now he's only threatening 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have 13 life. That's still not ideal, but he has to get through my taunter.
Job done.
What?
Another abomination. At this point, I have to kill his abomination to wipe the board. The only thing that would not die is the Undertaker, but we're going to take care of that right now.
I must attack the minion with taunt.
Right. Okay. He'll still... I guess I gotta do this. May as well. Alright. Possible I could dig myself out of this now. I just don't think it's very likely. That's a good help. Alright, he's threatening lethal.
Give me a big hug!
So I need to do that. Yeah, he gets to duplicate. That's fine. Six. I'd give him far too many skeletons. The moment I don't die. Feel much better about this with a Voidwalker.
Bring out your dead.
That's fine.
Bring out your dead.
Keep rolling. Yep. Oh, that hurts. I have to be able to kill him here, which basically means I'm looking for a top deck. Not that. I got 2, 3, 4, 5 damage. That's not gonna do it. No, I'm just gonna miss. I can kill a lot of his guys here. It's all enemy minions. Can I stop him from killing me, though? The answer, I think, is maybe. Nope. That's exactly lethal. Ugh, so close that time. All right. If you are just joining me, this is Doc Stout. I am attempting Murlocs Invade Naxxramas, the Plague Corps. So far, it's not going so well for us. Going against Noth the Plaguebringer, who gets to raise dead every time he kills one of my guys, and so far he's been very successful at doing that. Come close a couple of times, but haven't quite got there yet. Strikes me as a little bit of a mismatch, but I think with the right hand, we can overwhelm him.
Gul'dan versus Noth the Plaguebringer!
Another soul for the collection.
Your soul shall be mine!
In this situation, Voidwalker's actually very good. I want my Soulfires, but I need them late game. If I had top-decked a Soulfire in the last attempt, I would have gotten there. Iron Beak Owls have proven essential to turn off the Taunters. I think.